Welcome. In this video, we'll see the logical instructions present in 8051. So first we'll start with the ANDing instructions. So for ANDing, we have ANL as the mnemonic. So first instruction is ANL A, R6. So the meaning of this instruction is that the value present in R6 register will be ANDed with the value present in accumulator, and the result will be stored in accumulator. So here we have considered the value 77 hex in accumulator and the value in R6 as 07 hex. So I will just put that value in this register. So R6 is going to have value 07 hex. So I will put 07, and in accumulator we are having the value 77 hex. So the ANDing operation works in this way. So I have written here the value present in accumulator, that is 77 hex, and the value present in R6 as 07 hex. So if I AND these two together, I will get this as the result. So how the ANDing operation works: whenever both the bits are 1, only then we'll get 1, and whenever one of the bit is 1 and the other one is 0, the output will be 0. So this is nothing but the logic of AND gate. So the same thing is implemented over here. So the result will be 07 hex. So let's check the output. So if I execute this instruction, I will get 07 hex in accumulator. So we have got here 07 hex. Now this instruction is of register addressing mode, because both of the operands are registers, and this instruction is a 1-byte instruction because it just requires an opcode for representation. Next instruction is ANL A, 24 hex. So here in this instruction, 24 hex is the direct address of RAM memory location. So the meaning of this instruction is that the value present in 24 hex address location will be ANDed with the value present in accumulator, and the result will be stored in accumulator. So let us put some value at 24 hex address location. So I have put the value 45 hex at 24 hex location. So the value present in accumulator is 07 hex. So if I execute this instruction, I will get the result in accumulator, that is 05 hex. You can verify the result on your own. The result is similar to I have shown in the first example. Now in this instruction, the addressing mode of this instruction is direct addressing mode. The instruction is of 2 bytes. 1 byte is required for opcode and 1 byte is required for the direct address. Next instruction is ANL A, R1. So this instruction is of indirect addressing mode, and it requires only 1 byte, that is for opcode. So the meaning of this instruction is that the R1 register will act as a pointer. It is going to point to some memory location in RAM, and the value present at that memory location will be ANDed with the value present in accumulator, and the result will be stored in accumulator. So let us put some value, like for example, I will put 24 hex value in R1 register. So the meaning of this instruction is, now R1 register is going to point to address location 24 hex in internal RAM. So we have the value 45 hex at 24 hex location, and the value present in accumulator is 05. So if I execute this, the value present in accumulator remains 05, because the ANDing operation of 45 hex and 05 hex is 5. So the result is 5. Next, in this instruction, ANL A, #20 hex. So now, since hash symbol is present in this instruction is of immediate addressing mode, and this is the immediate value. So the value present in accumulator will be ANDed with the value 20 hex, and the result will be stored in accumulator. Now this instruction is of 2 bytes. 1 byte is required for opcode and 1 byte is required for storing this 8-bit immediate data. And this instruction is of immediate addressing mode. So the value present in accumulator is 5, and if it is ANDed with 20 hex, we'll get 00 in accumulator, because ANDing of 20 and 5 is 0. So this next instruction is ANL 35 hex, A. So in this instruction, 35 hex is the direct address, and it is address location of RAM memory. So the meaning of this instruction is that the value present in accumulator will be ANDed with the value present at 35 hex address location, and the result will be stored at 35 hex address location. So let me put some value in 35 hex address location. So I have put 78, and let us put some value in accumulator as well. So let it be 44 hex. So when these two values are ANDed together, the result of this instruction will be stored at 35 hex address location. So the result is 40 hex. Next instruction is ANL 40 hex comma hash 40. Now in this case, this first 40, that is a direct address, whereas this 40 is a immediate data. So since hash symbol is there, it means that whatever value we have written after hash symbol, that is immediate data. So the meaning of this instruction is that the value 40 hex will be ANDed with the value present at memory location 40 hex. So first of all, we have to go to memory location 40 hex. So here we have a 00. So here we can put any value, for example, 41 hex. So this 41 hex will be ANDed with value 40, and the result will be stored again at same location, that is 40 hex. So the result of ANDing 40 and 41 value is 40, and it is stored at this 40 address location. So these are the ANDing instructions present in 8051. The ORing instructions are also same. The ORing instructions are also available in 8051. Those are also having the same kind of syntax. Just the mnemonic is different. Instead of ANL for ORing, we have to use ORL. So I have just explained the first instruction here. So let us assume that accumulator is having value 77 hex and R6 register is having value 07 hex. So I will put value in accumulator as 77 hex, and value in R6 is already 07 hex. So if I OR these two values together, so it will work according to the logic of OR gate. So whenever we have 00, only then we'll get 0 as the output. Otherwise, the output will be 1. So here, ORing of these two values gives us this result, that is 77 hex. So let us check the output of the first instruction, that is ORL A comma R6. So the meaning of this instruction is that the value present in R6 will be ORed with the value present in accumulator, and the result will be stored in accumulator. So if I execute that, the result is stored in accumulator, that is 77 hex. So this instruction is again of 1 byte. It just requires opcode for its representation, and it is of register addressing mode. So all other instructions are work in the similar way. Just instead of ANDing, now we are going to perform the ORing operation. Other things are same. Next set of instructions is for XORing. So again, these instructions are also similar to the previous ANDing and ORing instructions. Just the mnemonic is different. Instead of ANL or instead of ORL, we are having here XRL for XORing operation. So again, I have explained the first instruction. Let us assume that A is having value 77 hex and R6 is having value 07 hex. So if we XOR these two values together, then the result of this will be 70 hex. It works according to the logic of XOR gate. So XOR gate is called as inequality detector. So whenever both the values or both the bits are not equal, at that time output will be 1. And whenever both the bits are equal, the output will be 0. So here, that's why we have got as 70 hex. So this instruction is again of register addressing mode, and it requires only 1 byte for opcode. So let us check the output of that instruction. So accumulator is having 77 and R6 is having 07 hex. So if we XOR that, the result is 70 hex, which is present in the accumulator. So in the same way, we can check the output of the remaining instructions as well. So all the things are similar to the previous instructions. So this is about the logical operations present in 8051. Some of the logical operations are available, which we'll see in the next video. If you have any doubt or if you want more information, you can visit to the website given in the description of this video. Thank you.